Welcome back. A new bill headed to Governor Rick Scott's desk could allow Florida to start sharing voter information to make sure that people are not registered in other states. The Florida Senate unanimously approved that bill today. The measure would allow voter information sharing with other states if the effort is not controlled by the federal government. It also allows Florida to share driver license information. Currently, there is a partnership between 23 states and the District of Columbia to share information. President Donald Trump has made an issue of people who are registered to vote in more than one state, using it as one of the bedrocks of his claim that voter fraud is rampant in the U.S.
Last night, Sarasota City Commissioners took the first step toward banning a controversial therapy on minors called conversion therapy. It's described as a way to change an individual's sexual orientation using therapeutic methods. Several states and more than a dozen Florida cities have already banned conversion therapy on minors. Last night, in a 3-2 vote, commissioners voted to draft an ordinance that would make Sarasota next. We recently talked to a former conversion therapy patient via Skype in Gainesville who now speaks publicly against the practice.
I was a part of a very conservative evangelical church that being gay was wrong, was a sin. I went in that therapy and my hopes were in being able to be normal, be like the other guys. The therapy is unrealistic. You cannot change who someone genuinely is.
Monday night, when city commissioners...
Some believe there is a place for conversion therapy in some specific cases. Free speech groups have also gone to court to block similar ordinances.
Also at last night's meeting, Sarasota City Commissioner and the city manager got into a heated argument over Moat Marine Lab's plan to build a new aquarium at Nathan Benderson Park. The announcement of plans to build it outside of the Sarasota city limit caused Commissioner Hagen Brody to question City Manager Tom Barwin. Brody criticized Barwin for not intervening and doing more to keep the aquarium from leaving its current spot on City Island. Moat Marine plans to expand its operation on City Island into a full research facility while moving its aquarium close to I-75.
All right, time again to get a check on our warm weather today with Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan. Bob?
Well, good afternoon, everyone. A beautiful, warm day again. Third day in a row, we had record high temperatures. Today, 88 degrees, 1 degree above the record high of 87, set back in 1997. Look at our normal high, 74 degrees. So just ripping that apart as far as that temperature goes. And it's currently, it's cooled to 86. We have some sunshine out there, a few clouds, and east to southeast winds at 16 miles an hour. The pressure, 3029, which remains high and has done so, it seems like, all month long. KCK webcam showing calm conditions out there on the waters today. Good boating weather and a great beach weather, too, with the water temperature at 75. Any kind of sea breeze. There wasn't much, but it kept things a bit cooler right near the coast. Well, the evening planner looks like this tonight. 70 degrees by 11 o'clock tonight, and temperatures staying pretty warm overnight. Lows will be into the upper 60s, our typical lows right now, into the mid-50s. Statewide, it's nice all over. We'll have much more in our weather forecast in just a few.
Bob, thank you. Florida is one of only four states in the country that does not immediately restore voting rights to convicted felons who serve their full sentences.
But two separate efforts to change that are making progress here in the state. Alec Cohn joins us with a preview of tonight's topic on ABC 7 at 7. Alan?
Jacqueline, Florida accounts for nearly a quarter of all the disenfranchised voters in our country, with around 1.5 million former offenders unable to cast a ballot. The current law, which was revised by Governor Rick Scott, requires offenders to wait 5 years after their full sentences to apply for clemency. Then the right can only be restored by a board of four state executives, including the governor. The Fair Elections Legal Network challenged the system last year, and a judge just recently agreed to its unconstitutionality. Days earlier, a petition to reverse the law also received the 700,000 signatures necessary to place a constitutional amendment on a ballot this fall. Local offenders say a reversal would be life-changing.
Government-wise, I can't be of any impact. My opinions don't matter.
It's constantly a reminder that we will never be good enough to be welcomed back into the community.
Tonight at 7, find out more about the recent efforts to restore felons' voting rights in Florida sooner or later, and why something changing the law would swing Florida voters in future elections. Back to you.
Okay, Alan, thank you. While Northport City Commissioners are eager to move forward on development for Warm Mineral Springs, they want to make sure all their previous work is not wasted. Commissioners are discussing a potential contract with Kim Lee Horn and Associates regarding development of the 80 acres of the Springs. A major concern there is the contract directed Kimley Horn to redo tasks that were already done, specifically in evaluating the three existing buildings on that site. The City Commission directed staff to renegotiate the master plan agreement and have everything back to them by April 1st.
Port Manatee could soon help increase the economic impact of Manatee County. The executive director of Port Manatee is considering bringing back cruise service. Port Manatee currently handles cargo ships, unloading everything from fuel, fruit, lumber, supplies for road building, and much more. In the past, though, the Regal Empress called Port Manatee home for 10 years and offered cruises to destinations in Mexico and the Western Caribbean. The east coast of Florida has cruise ports in Cape Canaveral, Fort Lauderdale, Jacksonville, Miami, and Palm Beach. However, the west coast of the state only has one, and that's in Tampa. So the port's executive director believes there could definitely be a future for cruise lines at Port Manatee.
A Florida beach is once again ranked the best nationwide, but this year, it is not Siesta Beach. Clearwater Beach grabbing the top spot in the TripAdvisor's Traveler's Choice Awards for 2018. Siesta Beach fell to number two this year. The Sunshine State, though, has six of the top 10 beaches on this year's list. TripAdvisor says soft sand, clear waters, and balmy temperatures are common threads among the Traveler's Choice Award winning beaches. I'm a little biased, but I think Siesta is still number one.
You know, I think I would agree with you. I absolutely love that beach, that powder-like sand. It's just beautiful.
You don't find it anywhere else, for sure. Still to come in your Suncoast News.
Step inside Selby Gardens and find out what Andy Warhol's factory was all about.
Sarasota Opera's 2018 Winter Opera Festival is here, featuring Puccini's Manon Lescaut, Bizet's Carmen, Bellini's Norma, and D'Albert's rarely heard Tiflant. For more information, go to sarasotaopera.org.
Stay connected to your clients and new customers using ABC7 Digital Media Services. Our team of professionals provide a wide array of digital services to help you get the most out of your website. We specialize in building and helping you maintain the most effective digital solutions for your business. It's vital that your online presence stands out, so our experts will equip you with the best resources available. Trust ABC7 Digital Media Services to give you the right tools to grow your business.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. We promise we're more than a dealership. We're a destination with a movie theater, massage room, aquarium, cafe, and more. We promise to give you top dollar for your trade, even if you don't buy from us. And if you do, we promise you the best deal. Bring us any competitor's ad, and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
Head over to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota, where you'll always get better prices and a bigger selection. Like the area's largest selection of new 2018 Jeep Wrangler JLs in stock now. Or get the most awarded SUV of all time, a new Jeep Cherokee, for as little as $19,999. Find the path to your next great adventure in the all-new Jeep Compass for just $18,999. Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
I owed the IRS $10,000.
I owed the IRS $20,000.
The IRS garnished my wages.
They put a lien on my house.
The IRS is the most powerful collection agency in the world. They do not give up until you pay.
I couldn't sleep. We were being audited. I called Tax Solutions Now, and a great big weight was lifted off my shoulders.
I called Tax Solutions Now, and they got the IRS off my back.
Tax Solutions Now had my wage garnishment lifted in 48 hours.
Tax Solutions Now can get you help. Our agents know the rules, can stop the pain, and get you the best deal.
We saved our home and overcame the most powerful collection agency in the world.
We connect you with a team of former IRS agents and tax professionals who get the IRS off your back.
Time is running out. Call Tax Solutions Now.
Call 1-800-565-7740. That's 1-800-565-7740.
In the spotlight tonight, something you can't find anywhere else but Sarasota.
ABC 7's Linda Carson takes us inside the Andy Warhol exhibit at Selby Botanical Gardens.
When you think of Andy Warhol, you probably think of Campbell soup cans and celebrity portraits. Nature doesn't come to mind, but this exhibit at Selby Botanical Gardens shows his deep connection.
In fact, during the course of Andy Warhol's career, he created 10,000 flowers. He also was a land preservationist who preserved acreage in both Montauk, Long Island, and in near Aspen, Colorado. And so this is the aspect Selby Gardens is exploring, Andy Warhol's surprising tie to nature.
This is not something you can find elsewhere.
This is the only place in the United States, actually the only place in the world that you can see this exhibit. Our horticulturists and botany team and facilities, they designed all of the elements that you see here. Our curator sourced all of the artwork, and we've really given a whole new look at Andy Warhol and his art, and shown that he has an affection for flowers.
You start your tour in the conservatory.
The conservatory display is almost as if Warhol could paint with plants. This is what we've evoked.
You see key tenets of his work.
He was really a proponent of repetition, the grid, bright pops of color, and modular form. And our team really applied those principles to the display in the conservatory.
And you see it again as you tour his floral playground.
As you go through the exhibit, you'll notice there are a lot of squares, a lot of grids, a lot of repeating patterns and colors. Everything is very well formatted and thought out. And that's a lot like the artwork of Andy Warhol. Everything looks almost the same, but not quite. There's something that's a little different in each one, so it makes you pay attention to the finer details.
And finally, you wind up in the Museum of Botany and Arts,
where there are amazing archival photographs on display of Warhol in nature, which is very unexpected. Things like Warhol rowing a boat and skiing, as well as original artworks by the artist, all featuring botanical imagery and flowers.
She says the exhibit ties together Sarasota's greatest strength, our love of art, culture, and nature. And there'll be more exhibits like this in the future.
This exhibit is the second in the Gene and Alfred Goldstein exhibition series that connects art to nature in a new context. And this is an ongoing series, and we look forward to continuing the program with new exhibits to come every February.
Warhol, Flowers in the Factory. It's at Selby Gardens through June 10th. You can find your 15 minutes of fame right here. Linda Carson, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
Now your ABC 7 First Alert weather forecast with Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan.
Well, good evening, everyone. I'm Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan. A beautiful day again today. Lots of sunshine out there. Occasionally some clouds moving in, but look how flat calm the water is there at Bimini Bay. And a beautiful sunset anticipated tonight. A third day of record high temperatures. That's right, for Florida, for Suncoast, we had 90 yesterday. It was a little cooler today, 88 degrees. It set the old mark of 87 back in 1979. Look for a warm weekend. Now, I don't think it'll be a record-breaking, but we'll see warm weekend with temperatures running about 10 degrees above average. And then there is a cooler weather pattern heading our way, but it doesn't happen until it looks like the 1st of March, and it looks like things will be cooling down just a little bit. Look how cold things are here, though. Freezing rain and snow into Kansas and Oklahoma and parts of Texas tonight. Well, you can see that steady east wind on the visible satellite imagery. The GOES 16 satellite, the one that's about a year and a half old now. It was launched in 2016 in November, doing quite well out there. It's now known as GOES 16. It was GOESR. GOES R and GOES S is going to be launched from the Cape next week on Thursday at 5:02. So a new satellite, another one in a series, will be launched next week from the Cape. GOES S, it will become GOES 17, and it'll be for the western United States and out in the Pacific. Well, the Titan radar picture showing a lot of rainfall around now throughout much of Tennessee, western Tennessee anyway, down to Louisiana. This is the big threat here. Severe weather and tornadoes possible into southern Louisiana, also into the eastern portion of that state. We don't have anything going on here. Again, military exercises bringing some returns anyway out there in the Gulf of Mexico heading away from us. 86 the high today, or I should say the temperature right now after 88 degree high. Sunshine and the dew point 61, winds out of the east southeast. Pretty brisk at 16 miles an hour. And there it is, the old mark 87 and 97. 74 is our normal. And the low this morning was well above average, and looks like that will continue too. A fog, there's a slight threat for some patchy fog. Not a lot. We're not anticipating a very thick event as far as that goes, and it should burn off rather quickly. Temperatures in the 70s and 80s, cooler readings, 75 in Pensacola, 78 now in Miami, 79 in Key West. Closer to home, temperatures all into the 80s here. Wauchula, Bradenton, Miyaka City, Sarasota, Northport, Venice, all around 82, 83 degrees. Inglewood, you're at 81, and Cortez at 80. Typically, you would see some mid-70s here with the water temperature at 75, but because that wind is so brisk out of the east and southeast, we don't get that sea breeze developing, so that tends to cool things down right near the immediate coast, and that hasn't happened today. Day planner, well, high temperatures will be into the mid to upper 80s again tomorrow, and it'll happen around 3, 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We're anticipating a very warm day on Thursday, and if you're liking this warm weather, it's going to continue on into the weekend as we are not anticipating much change in our forecast. Well, let's get a look at what's happening for boaters. It looks like this. Winds will be out of the northeast at 5 to 10 knots tomorrow. Not much happening there. Light chop on the bays and inland waters. As far as the forecast goes tonight, mostly fair. Some patchy fog, mainly inland, upper 60s for lows. The extended forecast, warm tomorrow. Near record breaking, slightly cooler, but not much over the weekend. Looks to be another gorgeous weekend. We've had several in a row. And looks like temperatures cooling down just a little bit on Tuesday and Wednesday, and maybe even cooler still Thursday and Friday. We'll get down into the mid-70s, which is normal for this time of year, or average, if you will. Back to you.
Okay, thank you, Bob. Time now to check your First Alert traffic for the drive home. Traffic is backed up in the northbound lanes of I-75 in Sarasota near the B Bridge Road exit. Scott?
Thanks, Jacqueline. In consumer news, do you want to eat out without spending too much? Well, Mary Maloney has money-saving tips that won't take a bite out of your budget.
Just because you're on a budget doesn't mean you have to spend every night in your kitchen. If you want to go out, find gift cards at a discounted rate. Try giftcards.com or restaurants.com. For instance, you could get a $25 gift card to your favorite restaurant without having to pay the full $25. So you end up getting some of your food for free. Do your research and ask for deals. Many times, kids, seniors, and members of the military can eat for free. Plan to eat out on those special days and take the family. If you end up leaving a lot of food on your plate, ask your server for lunch-sized portions. Typically, it's cheaper while also being filling. And follow your favorite restaurant on social media. Many times, that's the first place restaurants announce deals or sales. For Consumer Watch, I'm Mary Maloney.
I think we could all use some of those tips and learn from those when you go out to eat.
Absolutely. Entertainment news is coming up next.
My name is Stefan Campagna. We're Ben Gates and Dramus, and here is your Law Tip of the Week. If you've been injured or arrested, I know this feels like the end of the road, but really it's the beginning of a long, potentially stressful process. So give us a call. Let us give you some peace of mind.
Thousands of award-winning Honda SUVs are on sale from $189 a month during the Honda President's Day sales event. You've got to see these SUVs. Get a surprisingly spacious 2018 HR-V, $189 a month, or step up to Pilot for $289 a month with available seating for eight. Plus, we have Motor Trend's SUV of the Year, the 2018 CR-V, and Ridgeline, a car and driver's 10 best, all on sale for up to $3,805 less than the competition at your local Honda dealer.
There's nothing like this, this trail in Alabama. It just goes from the northern part of the state to the southern part of the state. We see all kind of different terrains, great value, great fun. We've been coming for 18 years. We started off with a group of 8, grew to 12, and grew to 16. And we love it because where else can you get world-class golf courses with world-class accommodations? To be able to play these type of courses in this environment, and the difficulty keeps us coming back over and over and over again.
This is an important medical announcement. Bard IVC filters have been linked to punctured veins and problems with migration. Anyone who's received a Bard IVC filter must receive medical monitoring and may be entitled to substantial compensation. If you have the Bard Recovery G2 or G2 Express filter, you are in a class of patients who should be compensated for some expenses. Call now for a free assessment of your case and potential money damages. This call is confidential. There's no cost and you may be eligible. Juries have awarded millions of dollars to people who should have been warned about the risks of the Bard IVC filters. Call the IVC Filter Hotline if you or a loved one has received an IVC filter and experienced a vein puncture or required medical monitoring. You must call now.
Call 800-329-3089. 800-329-3089.
I took my first handful of pills, and that's when all my priorities seemed to change.
He would ask to use the bathroom in other people's homes.
He just assumed that they would have medication.
He'd go in their medicine cabinets and steal prescription drugs.
I wish I knew really what these prescription pills were.
We were so naive about the whole drug thing.
These are all synthetic forms of heroin.
Keep your medication locked up because you'll never notice that a pill is gone.
Mind your meds. Learn more from the Partnership for Drug-Free Kids.
Some big names in entertainment are showing their support for anti-gun violence, and a newly released movie continues to break records.
For the latest on what's happening in Hollywood, here's ABC's Jason Nathanson.
The widow of former Soundgarden frontman Chris Cornell is opening up for the first time since her husband's suicide last year in her first TV interview. Vicky Cornell tells Good Morning America Wednesday she thinks she could have done more.
I know that people say, you can't blame yourself, and, you know, I'm trying not to. But there were signs.
She says she thinks he was high on drugs or medication when he killed himself, and he never would have done it if he were sober. The upcoming anti-gun violence march in Washington, D.C. just got some big-name support and a lot of cash. George Clooney and wife Amal are giving $500,000 to the March for Our Lives demonstration. Clooney says his family will be there next month. And his move inspired Oprah, who says she's matching the donation, and she says the young people involved remind her of the Freedom Riders in the 60s. The records keep falling for Black Panther, this time the Marvel movie knocking Star Wars out of a top spot. Black Panther had the best Monday ever in North America, $40.2 million, beating the previous champ, Star Wars The Force Awakens, by $100,000. Worldwide, Black Panther will easily pass $500 million this week. And that's what's happening in Hollywood. I'm Jason Nathanson, ABC News, Los Angeles.
And the world's busiest airport is capitalizing on the buzz surrounding that big blockbuster. On Monday, the Atlanta airport tweeting an image of a gate listing a flight to Wakanda, the fictional African kingdom at the center of Black Panther. The tweet quickly generated a massive response from Atlanta's mayor to one of the film's stars joining in the fun. The posting isn't Black Panther's only tie to the city. Parts of the film were shot in the Atlanta area.
Singer Fergie is apologizing for her divisive national anthem performance at the NBA All-Star Game. The Grammy Award-winning artist sang a slowed-down, jazzed-up version of the Star-Spangled Banner. She was slammed on social media, even by those who acknowledge that it can be a difficult song to sing. According to People magazine, Fergie says she's a, quote, risk-taker artistically, but clearly this rendition did not strike the intended tone. She said she loves this country and honestly tried her best. Certainly an interesting take that we have not heard before when it comes to the Star-Spangled Banner.
That's one of those songs. I don't think you can go too far off
the
original intent of the song. I don't know. I go back to Whitney Houston's version.
There we go.
Super Bowl 25. Beautiful.
Beautiful one, of course. Anything with Whitney Houston, yeah. Really.
We'll be right back.
For the last decade, S&S Motorsports of Sarasota has built custom high-performance vehicles for demanding clients worldwide. They're now bringing their 50-plus years of combined build expertise to the parts business. SRQ Performance Parts is your one-stop shop for all your performance parts and accessories.
Head over to Sunset Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram in Sarasota, where you'll always get better prices and a bigger selection. Like the area's largest selection of 7-passenger vehicles. Get KBB's 2017 Best Buy Award overall winner, the Chrysler Pacifica, for just $25,999. Or load up the family in your new Dodge Grand Caravan for just $20,999. Drive away in a new Dodge Journey for as little as $17,999. Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, Ram in Sarasota.